be right back.
They ever did on it, me for the first one I got. There's like $15,000 worth of
that's why I'm laughing.
Stuff that I got right there to show.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you want to pull all your shit out, dude, I'll put it all on them this year. Make them give you back $50,000. I don't care. Yeah. Just get it to me. I'll put it on there. He's right, man. We spend a lot of money on cars, gas, labor, parts. Guess what? On that Volkswagen, that badass Passat that I drove for 125,000 miles going to work every day. Last year I drove 125,000 miles. I didn't even claim it. I wasn't going to get my tax return last year. I already knew that. I got fucked over out of my shit. And we'll get to that at some point. We got a long road to go. We got to recover, man. I can't just live my life in pain, man. I got to start talking about shit. All right, you line. 2, 3, 7, 3. Rent 2.
12,000.
12,000.
Utility, you need utilities?
Nope, not yet. Yeah, dude, we spent $12,000 in rent on our business address. That's fucking, that's a lot, dude. I'm taking federal money, ha, 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 and it's legal. You guys can't do shit about it, so fuck you. Taking all of it. Taking all your money. You hear me? IRS, I'm coming for your ass. I'm coming for your ass. I want all of it that we're owed. Just what we're owed, man. Now, back to where we were, though. A few weeks later, I just told you guys, I stole $27,000, and it was all in cash. It was all $100 bills. This guy came over, took like 20 Xanax bars, and showed off all his money. Took like a bunch of bars and fell asleep. What an idiot, bro. I took it. Took his shit. From this man, wow. He eventually woke up, and to no surprise, went ballistic. He lit a house on fire, and with me still inside, I woke up coughing to the smoke, and the smoke detector's going off like crazy. And see, that's how Xanax does it. You just skip to the next day, don't you? I left that day and went and spent like $3,000. Came back to the house, put the money underneath of it, and came inside, act like I don't know what the fuck is going on. I guess he didn't even know that I was there, but when he seen me, he pulled out a chrome long pistol and held it straight to my face, demanding his money. I hadn't taken it. I told him I didn't touch it. Nope. I pleaded for my life. Told him that I was asleep in the back room, and I heard the fire trucks coming at this point, and because he really lit this house on fire, and Oh, man. I got arrested. I was underage. I got arrested for being underage. I didn't have nobody else to call but my reading teacher, Tina Dutton. Within a few hours, I was being released into her custody at this police station. Obviously, the girl knew where the money was, and she told the guy where it was at. He went and got it. To my fucking, I didn't want to tell him nothing. I worked 3 different jobs. I graduated in high school in 2009 when I was just 15 years old. And this also allowed me to work 40 hours at Publix. I was able to put into savings and stock. I went to Burger King and got a second job there. And then at Arby's. Now I worked 3 jobs all year. And soon I would meet Carly Maroney and we'd be head over heels in love. For I would move into her home in Rockledge and be with her and her mother and her little brother. It's been almost 3 years now since that Christmas. I'll never forget the first time I heard my mom's voice again. She said she was hysterical, crying, apologizing. After 3 years, I had never changed my number, and one day she just called back and I picked up. Turns out she moved to Mississippi and felt really guilty about leaving me. And she tried to ignore it, but it would just make the pain. It would not make the pain go away. It never did. And it probably just made her go into terrible meth over addiction and overdoses. She overdosed 3 times on me. 3 times I had to drive her to the hospital before I got a license. And this was all, the, this was all before 2012. All right, here's where we get to the good part. Immediately started doing drugs. All right, I had been clean all the way up until then. I lived in I almost went to Mississippi with her. I wanted to. I had my own money. I had my own car. I had my own house. I was 16 years old. And I was living with Tina. At the same time, I graduated school. I just met Carly. We're fighting. She got pregnant. And August 10th, 2012, gave me the most beautiful little girl named Jamie Lynn Cookshot. And at the same time, I've been attending college classes on Kaplan University. I got 3 semesters in with a 4.0 GPA, made it on the president's list, and graduated with my associates in applied science and criminal justice in February 2012. I'll never forget how much me and that baby bonded while she was an infant. This was the best time of my life. I still do love her with all my heart, and more I will ever love than anything in the world. I realize now how I affect her every day, and looking forward to be a major part of her life very soon. This same year, in July, I started a business called Hourly Handyman Services, LLC, and registered it through the state of Florida in July 2012. So it was right before she was born. I registered my business with SunBiz, made it a corporation. December 31st, 2017, I ran this company all that time, subcontracting. I subcontracted for everyone. I went everywhere. I got into Academy Sports as cash room, changing out fans. I got shelving and Charming Charlie's. I'm working for Lifestyle Homes, AMAC Homes. You know, I'm just doing whatever, whenever. And it's been 5 years later. So 5 years later, different things, different handyman work, commercial service calls, new construction, cleaning and repairs for Tom Dutton and Lifestyle Homes. I had a contract with them to clean and insulate all the doors and windows and do all the fire retardant protection. And when they built the house, an average of 160 houses per year. They kept me very busy. I had 7 superintendents, and I had 13 or 17 different neighborhoods of houses. I bought my first home in 2013, 2,000 square foot, 3-bedroom, 2-bath, manufactured home, and it was beautiful, and I loved it. I bought a fairly new 2012 F-150 extended cab STX, all white, in October. I spent $26,000 on this truck, and it was regularly attending AA meetings, and after all I've been through in 2012, I had a major problem. And thanks to a felony conviction of burglary of an occupied and petty theft, I had got my life together. I was convicted by a jury of a crime I did not commit. I went to a service call, and I went with an idiot friend of mine, and he went in the gate and went inside somebody's boat and took something, and I didn't know it. But they got my tag off of my truck because I actually paid my bills, and I had a truck, and I had shit going on for myself. Man, that's another thing, man. That trial cost me to be a fucking felon. I would not be a felon today if that didn't happen. That guy lied on the stand, looked right at me. And then the judge would not let any of the other people testify on my behalf. Literally told them he would give them a year in jail if they tried. My boy had to come in and take the fifth. Raise his hand and take the fifth. I did 8 days in jail, and I did 9 months on probation. Largely thank you to Lifestyle Homes and the 19 character witnesses that showed up at my sentencing. And a $1 billion company, Lifestyle Homes Inc., with a letter of recommendation to keep me out of prison. It was a miracle. I stayed on track. I got Tom Nathan, the vice president, to get on the stand and actually speak about my integrity, my hard work ethic, and my ability to just handle so much. He said that he relied on my expertise and my diligence to complete 160 houses for the richest in Brevard. You gotta pay for that house up front. Yeah, and it's $300,000 and up. Better believe you're gonna spend a good mill if you want something with solar panels. We did a lot of solar panel houses. I couldn't believe it, man. He shut down the whole office, man. He brought the entire team to court because I thought I was gonna go to prison. I was out on a quarterman's bond, and that judge told me if I fucked up, I would get 16 years. 16 years in jail. Oh, man. I started doing drugs again. Over the next 2 years, I'd be arrested 17 times. I would total my truck after my insurance lapsed, which I found out later on it didn't lapse. I would piss away my savings. I would lose respect for myself, and I thought nothing about anybody else but getting high. It's 2018, and I'm in the dumpster. My future's bright. I thank the bridge and all they've done for me in such a short time. My strengths are loyalty, determined, dedicated, consistency, quick learner. My weaknesses are anxiety, stress, procrastinating, selfishness, and connection with God. I always felt was very short. My short-term goals is to find a stable place to rent and find balance between my job and my family. My old goal was to DUI class and other probation requirements, which I did, and I finished that. I paid off my driver's license, but then, oops, no, I really didn't. I thought I did. That's because when I went to court, I had two DUIs, one back-to-back, a week after the other one, and both times I blew a 0-0 and still got arrested for DUI. The guy said I was high. That's some bullshit. Wasn't high. I had to take a plea bargain because they locked me up in so many cases. I couldn't get out of jail. It's fucked. They completely fucked me. I couldn't get a lawyer back then. I hated myself. I couldn't get paid for shit. Now, I wrote this autobiography when I was in the bridge, and that's a rehab program that they sent me to for possession of alprazolam, which is Xanax. Today I feel like I can't ever be in the dumpster again. I got so much done for myself. I got so much going. I'm rich. I'm self-made millionaire. There's no doubt about it. I got absolutely no cash money that I can spend. But I do have one of the best life insurances that you can get. I turn the rich into a poor house. It's like conviction number 4 now. This says if I ever become disabled, my benefit will be $700 a month. And I paid to the end of my life until my 65th birthday, but not less than 24 months. Social Security benefits $600 per month, accidental death and disbursement benefit of $50,000, and $700 a month if I ever become disabled. I mean, that's a policy, bro. That's a life policy. Totally disabled, maximum benefit, $700 a month, every month. That's right. And I got another one of these paid off too. Let's get you $20,000. Let's do it. Let's get you $20,000 on your taxes. Come on. This man has done more transactions than anybody I know. 69 different bank transactions. There's another one. Laptop. Laptop purchase right there. Hell yeah. Within 90 days, I finished paying off my court costs. I attended 90 meetings and a place to get custody of my daughter through the court. I continued building my meditation skills, got involved with volunteering and active addicts, and I've had my driver's license. I had to buy a new truck. My 1 year goal now at this point, because I'm just at 90 days after leaving the bridge, and I have my driver's license. Buy a new truck and as nice as my last, and continue to be employed 1 year. Volunteer at a community organization and have full custody and live with my daughter in 1 year. This is 2016, 2017, some shit like that. My 5-year goal would be to own a home with my daughter, take her to school and pick her up every day, and be getting married, hopefully having more children. Be debt-free and build up my credit again. Tell you what, I'm nowhere near debt-free, but I am building my credit. My self-image is that I'm very smart, I'm outgoing, someone that's easy to get along with. I'm not someone that gets angry easily, and I'm very positive about my life. I can see, always see the bright side of things. I am happy, confident, very skilled in remodeling, and a general maintenance contractor. I have a good understanding of what I want and what I need out of life and how to get it. I very much look forward to the future and raising my daughter, continue to live a sober life. Significant events. I was born August 31st, 1992. 2008, I got legally emancipated and was an adult. Moved in with Tina. 2009, graduated high school. 2012, graduated college with my associate's degree, and I got arrested for burglary. Convicted by a jury in 2012. Started Hourly Handyman Services LLC. Began to work with Lifestyle Homes. Jamie Lynn was born, and I wrecked my nice new truck. Bought me a nice new truck. Had it for like 3 years. Busted my ass for like 3 straight years. I did 2012 to 2015. I made $53,000 from Lifestyle Homes alone every year. And then I worked for 19 different subcontracting companies. I'd have guys in Miami, Orlando, and Jacksonville at the same time running off of my company and doing repairs at $90 an hour. 16 times I was arrested. All right. The cops here, man, for bars is the worst. It is, it's the worst. If you would like to purchase a copy of my story, hit me up on the web chat. There's my table of contents. I read it to you guys. It's not that great, really. I think it sucks. But I was in a program and I was trying to get out of there. Successfully completed that program and I left there with $1,600 in my pocket. Saved it up. Plus, I got like 3 copies of that fucking book, man. Somebody should buy that shit, man. Give me $50. I'll take $50. Anybody out there? This is my general maintenance sheet. I gotta remember, man. I gotta keep just reading my prayers, and I just get so anxious. The best and most beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt. Shit, just for 2 seconds. I'm like a distracted kid, man. So distracted.
You know, it's interesting. I guess, you know, that I only made like $8,000 the last 3 months of the year. That's not even $3,000 a month.
Put it this way. If you would have made, you could have made an extra.
Oh, I know the difference. They're not counting all the shipping fees.
That's what I know. Yeah, you gotta get those.
Or the fees that they charge.
Yeah, no. That's
what they sent.
This year
that's
I got
just
it.
What they sent my bank.
Yeah, but you still have to go on to PayPal. Go to PayPal. Create a report and print it.
For
the entire year. For the entire year. Just one report for the entire year. I'm about to go claim bankruptcy. Little do they know, I just spent fucking all my money on life insurance. I'm not gonna let my baby go without. Yeah, he like me. A lot of kids like me wanna fight me. Me, I'm icy, that's what I like you. If I died right now from a natural cause, my daughter would receive $150,000 of benefits on my whole life term policy, and then she would also get $700 a month. And it's all thanks to Jack Rogers. Thanks, Jack. Love you, man. Rest in peace. You know, I got robbed yesterday, man. Somebody hacked into my PayPal account and took $500 off of my fucking debit card. I had to get on the phone with fraud, and they said they might give me a temporary credit. I gotta find out. Rent $12,000 this year. Didn't get no kind of help on his rent. How do you get this man help on his rent, man? He's my dog, man. John's my dog. He's fucking a miracle. He's amazing. Man can sell some fucking records, too. I'm a tax expert. I am an IRS certified volunteer for the elderly. I have my PTIN, my ITIN, my FEIN. File a simple return. They're very good the things I do. Remember, we still hold our own fate. We still have time. Young rich man.
You know, so we ain't really never had no old money.
You never knew you had this old money.
We got a whole lot of new money, though.
Got a whole lot of new money.
Hey! Raindrops.
Drop top. Stripping up cooking on a hot box. I came up from there just something, nigga. I don't trust nobody. Gotta find the bottom out of here. Started from the bottom. I'm gonna get one of these houses with this pool. Excuse me, please me. I must believe me, It be, cause I'm flexing Rari's. You can hurl me. Tater top, fuck niggas on the radar watch. Fuck that box. 769.97 in total medical expenses for my friend this year. Wow. 319.55 was his planned share. Fun. I don't need him. Talking strong, but you're leaving. Taxes on rent? Good question. I believe you pay taxes in your rent. But, I don't know. This is straight $12,000. You lying. I know he pays taxes. Slippery. Excuse me. Please me. Believe me, get beat, cause I'm flexing Rari's, you can bet on me. She know my mean to talk to me, hold it, I'd like to be. Man, what are we gonna do about this, man? The sheriff's gotta go, dude, he sucks. I'm probably gonna hold it for you, you lying. $327.89 a month. Boxes. Some people make good money. $2,373 in total. Thank you. Financial summary. Hammer Records. 35,000 in credit, though. 36. Yeah. 36,000. Nice.
There. That's the total I made.
Yeah, I know. It's fucking sweet.
What did it say on how much were the fees that they took out?
$1,794. Yeah. Maybe an unprovoked violence. $1,794.28 in PayPal fees. PayPal, you rock. Go Elon Musk. $1,773 they kept on hold. And $1,268 in refunds. They didn't know where to keep it locked. Oh, shit. Other fees, $21. Total transfers and withdrawals, $7,000. Transfer to PayPal. Okay, purchase activity, $25,000. Jeez. Excuse me. Please me. Believe me. It be. Cause I'm flexing Rari's. Purchase tax, $25,784.32. That's what he spent to keep his eBay store running. And debit card purchases, $151.95. Damn, that's quite a bit. And other, $304.
Nothing unusual there.
This man hasn't taken a dime from unemployment. It's crazy. I got 19 grand out of them. Still got to multiply the tax on $2,300. I got this one.
To travel beyond our living rooms. To hug our parents and grandparents.
Yo!
To get back to normal. We just need to hold on a little bit longer.
The public's
pharmacies are quickly administered.
He's got $331 in his account. I was going to ask him to buy me some stuff.
Stay patient. More vaccine.
Charging $400 to his taxes. Ooh, I can deduct that too. $425. Don't care who you are, what your situation is. Come to me to do your taxes, and I will do the best I can for you. Please consult with an individual tax preparer, legal counsel, or Internal Revenue Service for filing of this form. Principal cannot be provided tax advice. So keep a copy of this form. The statement's available online at principal.com. Keep it 100, just be real with me. Eat it up like it's a feast. Even though they're gonna be like that with me. It's a very good issue with me. At my height, my business made 20 huge accomplishments. One of them was have a net income of $6,468. It's not very much. $6,000 I walked away after one whole year of working. But I made a gross profit of $98,880.98. Spent $88,362 doing it. 300 cash, and that boy came with a blunt in it. And she got ass, and we gon' fuck up a bag. And but it's spot, living too fast. Gotta just open the stack. The Legislative Affairs supervises and coordinates the department's legislative agenda and assists in developing effective legislation policy and initiatives on behalf of the department. The office also tracks and assesses.